Gaffer, devastating way to end a brilliant season. How are you feeling at the moment?
Yeah, just that word, devastated. It's, obviously, it's not the way we wanted today to go. Felt that it might not have been the case if we'd have scored our chances early on that we created. It's a different game, but you know, the goals that we conceded, one's a moment of quality and the other two are poor from set plays just before half-time, and then the red card kills it as a contest, and playing MK Dons with one man down is probably the worst team you want to play.
Does that highlight kind of the fine margins and how things can get away from you quite quickly? I mean, just before they took the lead, we had two great chances, didn't we? It could have been a different game.
Yeah, it is fine margins, and at the top end of the division when the games are tight, when you've got to take them opportunities that you get. We created two unbelievable chances, two lovely bits of play, and he fell to a player who you'd wanted to fall to, but he has met the target both times, and yes, it's probably the difference in the game.
What can you say, what do you say to the players after that? And the walking wounded, they gave everything this season, just came up a little bit short.
Yeah, I just said to them before the game, even before it started, said that no matter what happened, I'm proud of them. Every single one of them have given us everything, 100% every single week, and the journey that we've been on has been an incredible one for us to be competing, fighting for the playoffs on the last day with these big teams in League One. It's a brilliant achievement. So I was proud of them before the game, and I'm still proud of them at the end of the game.
A word on the fans, it's easy to be loud when it's going with you, but they stayed with you right to the end. They even chanted happy birthday in the second half.
They did, I heard that. Yeah, that put a smile on my face, and it wasn't an easy day, obviously, when they're conceding goals and chances like that in the second half. It was, you know, it was a real horrible 45 minutes, but for them to stick with us, we asked them that. Well, at the start of the week, I asked to stick behind the team because it was going to be a hard day, and it was a difficult day, and we needed them. And yeah, thank you for all of the support throughout the whole season, not just today.
It's been a grueling season. What does the next week or so now look like for you?
I'm going to have a rest for a few days, definitely going to switch off a little bit because it's been emotional, stressful, enjoyable as well. But I want to go away now and have a couple of days down time, not think about football for a few days, to be honest, and then get back to work back in the next week.
Obviously, very positive season, took it right to the last game. Most of this group is still here, still under contract. You've got the building blocks already for next season, haven't you?
Yeah, and that's a positive. And we said that at the end then to the players. We said, look, we've had an unbelievable season, and next year we'll get better. We have to go and invest. We've got to go and get some better players in that, in the big games against the top six. We've got a little bit more quality that can win games for you. So we need to find them. They don't come cheap, but we'll have to work our hardest to try and get them and continue to improve and move forward as a club. I think this year we've had a massive improvement from where we were last year. If we have a little bit more of an improvement next year, then we'll be okay, but it won't be easy. And we're going to need, as I say, backing and help to try and make that team better. But as you say, we've got the majority in the nucleus of a good squad, and we'll be ready to go again in June.